Hello everyone. Today we will discuss a concept in Docker which is known as Docker Compose. Docker Compose is basically used for creating the same multi-container architecture that we have created in one of our previous videos using the hyphen hyphen link option. In those sessions, if you look at my previous videos on linking of Docker containers, I have explained how multiple containers can be linked with each other using a run command option called hyphen hyphen link. And we also discussed that it's actually a deprecated way. It's an outdated way of linking containers. Upcoming versions of Docker might or might not support that. So there are better ways for linking Docker containers. And one of that is, you know, for creating a multi-container architecture, one of those ways is using something known as Docker Compose. When we use the word Docker Compose, when we use the word Docker Compose, please understand, Docker Compose actually is created. I mean, we can create this Docker Compose using YAML files. Okay. And once these Docker Compose YAML files are defined, you will see that they are reusable, which means whatever multi-container architecture you are planning to create, whether it's a development environment or a testing environment, all those environments can be created or they can be destroyed in a much more reusable format compared to what we have seen with the regular Docker run command. Okay. So what is the advantage? Let's take the same example that we have seen in the earlier sessions. We have created a MySQL Docker container and we link this MySQL Docker container with a WordPress container, right? Now, once this was done, we said that this is a development environment where a WordPress developer should be able to create his WordPress website, and all the data related to this WordPress website will be stored in the MySQL database. This is what we discussed. But we created this environment using a Docker run option known as link, hyphen hyphen link. Now we will create the same environment using Docker Compose. Once it is created, you will see that Docker Compose is by far much more reusable than your regular Docker run commands. Okay. So the first activity is you go to the Docker host. Docker host is nothing but the machine where Docker is installed. In my case, I have installed Docker on a Ubuntu AWS instance, and this is that instance. Okay. We can check for the version of Docker. Simply say Docker hyphen hyphen version, and you see that this is the current version of Docker that I'm using. Now on this Docker machine, I mean, this is just a Ubuntu Linux server where Docker is installed. On this, we need to install Docker Compose. How do you install Docker Compose? It's pretty simple. All you have to do is just go into Google and there we type Docker Compose install. Once we do that, it will take us to the official Docker documentation. Click on it. And you know, you can actually read all this information related to Docker Compose. It's very good documentation. But if you come on, if you come a little down on this page, we'll find an option Linux, because currently we are trying to install it on a Linux machine. I'll just click Linux. And when I do that, they have shown you what are the exact commands. This is the curl command which is going to download the Docker Compose software into our Linux servers. Okay, so I'll just copy that curl command, paste it. And once it is downloaded, the next thing we have to do is give execute permissions. And this is the command for doing that. So just. Okay, it's done. You want to check which version of Docker Compose has been installed. I can simply say Docker Compose hyphen hyphen version, and it shows that I am using Docker Compose 1.25.3 version. It's as simple as that. We come to this official Docker documentation site. For the sake of your convenience, maybe I'll paste it in my text file. I'll also paste it in the notes. So this is the location where we can download the Docker Compose software. Just give me a second. Yeah, so maybe it's better now. So this is the Docker Compose. This is the location from where you can download and install Docker Compose, okay, on a Linux server. Similarly, they have given you various options. If you want to install Docker on a Windows machine or a Windows server, different servers, depending on the kind of operating system, you decide and you do the installation. Now, once the Docker Compose has been installed, now how do you create the Docker Compose files? As I told you earlier, I want to take up an example, a very simple example where we would like to link a WordPress container with a MySQL 5 version container, MySQL 5 image I want to use, okay? And this we want to create via the Docker Compose YAML file. So let's start. I'll create a file. The name of the file should be docker-compose.yml. In fact, we can give some other name also, but how it is given, we'll try to see that also. But as of now, just imagine that the name of the file should be docker-compose.yml. And once you do that, generally the YAML files, it's a convention that we follow in YAML, that YAML files start with three hyphens and they end with three dots. It's not mandatory. It's a convention that we follow. It's a good practice. Now, YAML, XML, JSON, all these are just used for storing the data in key value pairs. That's the purpose. These are not scripting languages or programming languages. They're just used for storing some data in the format of keys and values. And in a YAML file, the parent-child relationship is always represented by one space, a space or a tab space, but it should be same throughout the file. Now, you start with version. And here you specify the version as 3. The next element we need to give is services. When you say services, in the services section, we need to specify what are the different containers that we would like to start. I want to start, the MySQL container. So I'll say MyDB. This is the name of the container. Did you observe version and services we have given at the same level? The indentation is same. Why did we give them at the same level? Because they are sibling elements. Both of them are sibling elements. Okay, just a second. They are just sibling elements. Whereas in services, the name of the container that we are going to create, it's a child element. And this container can be created based on which image? I would like to create it based on MySQL 5 image. So with this, a MySQL 5 image will start. And all of us know that when you're starting a MySQL container, we also need to pass an environment variable. So this is how you pass the environment variable. Environment variable. What was the environment variable that we were using? MySQL underscore root underscore password. And I would like my password to be IntelliQIT. You can give whatever you want. Okay. Already in the previous session of Docker linking, we have discussed why this environment variable, how do you know which environment has to be passed? All that has been discussed, right? So once this is over, the next container that I would like to start is a WordPress container. So I'll call this as WordPress, my WordPress, and this my WordPress should be created based on which image? WordPress image. WordPress is a web server. We generally access it from a browser. So I'll give the port mapping. The WordPress container runs on a port 80. You link it with whichever port number you want. I will link it with 9090, which means the container port 80 is linked with the host port 9090. Finish. I mean, this is sufficient. But because we have learned the links concept and all that, I would also want to specify that this WordPress container should be linked with the MyDB container. This is not mandatory. Even if you don't give it also, it'll work. But let's give it. The name of the container is MyDB. Some alias. I'll give the alias as MySQL. Finish. My Docker Compose file is created. Once the Docker Compose file is created, you can clearly see that this Docker Compose file is talking about creating two Docker containers, one out of a MySQL image and other one from a WordPress image. So if you simply take this Docker Compose file and if you fire the command docker-compose up, this is sufficient. Whatever containers information has been given in the Docker Compose file, all those containers would be created and they will start. But generally these containers would generate some logs on my screen. I don't want all that nonsense to come. So I would like to run in the background. Hyphen D, as all of you know, runs this container set in detached mode. So all the containers would start, but you don't see those logs coming up on the screen. Okay, so let's run the program, finish. You see, initially it's creating a database. Now it's creating a WordPress. It's done. What is the proof? Look at the list of containers which are running. Docker container ls clearly shows that a WordPress container has been created with whatever port mapping that we expected. You can see that it got created 10 seconds back. A MySQL container also got created. It got created 12 seconds back. Now, if the WordPress and MySQL are really linked with each other, as we have seen in the last session, I should be able to access this WordPress from a browser, right? So let's do that. You go to the AWS dashboard. You take the public IP of this instance where Docker has been installed. I'll just paste it in the browser. And what was the port number we have given? 9090. So I should be able to access the home page of the WordPress. I hope you are understanding. The same thing in the last session, I have discussed how to do it with the hyphen hyphen link option. Currently we are trying to do it with the Docker Compose. Okay, so the main advantage is, as I told you, reusability. Once your requirement is over and you would like to stop and delete all these services, the command you can give is Docker Compose. If you say stop, the services will stop. Whereas if you say down, the services will be stopped and the containers would be deleted. Finish. It's as simple as that. It's as simple as that. The containers are deleted. And now if you fire Docker container ls, I should not find any containers. Okay, a very simple example for demonstrating how Docker Compose works. We'll take up much more better scenarios and bigger and complex scenarios, okay, of how the Docker Compose file can be used for creating different types of development environment or testing environment, etc. Okay, so we'll stop the session for now. Thanks a lot for watching the video. Bye.